business setup, and we will have no problem. And this world is interdependent. We cannot isolate ourselves. So my question, quickly, but just one question I want to ask, is: do you really believe in what we are saying, or is just something for discussion? Thank you.
Thank you.
MashaAllah, yani I'm lucky today. I have a few of my schoolmates. Muhammad is a schoolmate. Haven't seen him for quite a while. Yani. But actually, what I'm talking about doesn't contradict or conflict with what Muhammad is saying. I'm saying there are different roles for different parts of the food supply chain. We need to increase the capacity. We need to really look at the availability issue. And as you mentioned, availability doesn't mean it has to be within the country, because the fact of the matter, you are water poor country. So you go to water rich countries. And we have a role to play there. The issue of about land ownership, you don't have to own the land. But you see, part, an important part of the chain where there are specialized players who are playing that part is the part of the logistic player and the distributor and the processor. And I gave examples of the five largest distributors who control almost 80% of the cross-border trade in the world, who are originators. And I've seen the investment there isn't very large. Yet they provide and they add to your security because they give you the diversity. Because even countries that are food rich, like Argentina, like Thailand, in certain periods, they had bans on exports of certain products. So having a diversity is an important element as well and a factor in your food security. So I'm not really, I agree with you.
Thank you, Dr. Sami. We'll take a question from mic number 4. And please keep your question short or comment to the point so we can answer. Please, number 4.
My name is Uta Gruda. I'm calling from Germany. And my company is GCC Germany Business Invest. My question in this session is following. My company is is cooperating with a big organization in Germany, and we are the responsibility for 1,500 German company. And in this number are also a lot of German company that are working in food business or in food production. My question is, what are your efforts or what do you plan for Saudi side to cooperate with these companies in Germany? Why to cooperate only with another countries like Sudan or India or something else and not with the countries like Germany? Because we know exactly we're working very closely that this company in food business, they are very interested also to set up business in Saudi. What do you plan in the near future to cooperate more and to see more to cooperate with these countries like Germany? Thank you.
Thank you. Dr. Sam?
I guess when we look at investment, we have, scoped the area in which we play, and the area is the MENACA region, is the OICE region, Organization of Islamic Conference. This is where we as Saudi investors feel more comfortable and as well have a more favored position as investors. And it's a large region that is underserved, and there aren't large multinationals who are playing that, the space. We currently are the largest players in oil processing. We're in 11 countries. We are effectively the largest producer of branded edible oil in the world, mainly through operating in this region. And yet, there is so much more to do because we're in sugar and we're looking at other ambient stable commodities within this region where the space still is not occupied by any global or international players. But we'd work with European companies, and we had a joint venture with Tate & Lyle, the largest sugar producer of refineries, you know, in no longer they're exiting that industry, but one day they were when we joined together. And we'd be willing to look at JVs where we could bring know-how and technology into the region.
To give probably a general answer to this is companies usually look for the best opportunities. If their best opportunities is with a company in the United States, they will look for it. If you present them with the best opportunity, and it depends on the kind of activity they have. If they have a farming activity, they will go to where would the companies in Germany would go in order to farm. I hope that will probably shed some light on some of the sides of it. Number five.
I'll speak in English so everybody can benefit. I think that this subject is, the food security subject, is way off target for a city like Jeddah. We need to know how to help retain our water to begin with, not to damage us. We have not reached a point where we have a plan for drinking water, not agriculture. To me, food security should tackle the polluted drinking water that we drink every day in Jeddah and the availability of water in summer. We're still at the stage of hope, which is not the plan.
It's a comment. Thank you.
When we talk about agriculture development here, we're not talking about only in Jeddah, i.e., if we talk about Taif, we can grow roses there, not for the purpose of exporting roses, but to get the roses as subsidized to keep the rural area in their villages. Same as on the beaches, which is we can support it in Jizan or in the north or in the south. We can